which is the output for them, including the first parameter is that, the second one is that, the third one is blah blah, and that means the output is blah blah. For example, you have some input and output balance past samples, so that means supervised learning. Your system just adapts itself by looking at which inputs are connected to which outputs from the past states, known solutions. So your system will be adaptable to the future states to determine exact output to future states which are not visible in terms of past states. So in that way, your system just saves some optimization-oriented parameter adjustments to reach to some prediction or pattern recognition or other problem solution-oriented adapted machine-learned systems, dear friends. That is the way of the using the learning styles in terms of machine learning. And of course, the most critical learning style for the machine learning and for the future of AI is reinforcement learning. Reinforcement learning means it is the use of the lifelong learning or learning with experiences for the machine learning, which means you just model your system that you say that if you hit a wall, just change your wave. If you do not hit a wall, just go along that way. That means a robot can be having some learning by experiences by hitting some walls and determining an exact way, which way belongs to the free wave, leading to not walls, not hitting any sides of the room, but going to the true sides of the room, or by using some environmental factors like hitting a robot, your robot can be learning that yes, this region is somehow dangerous, so I should be being far from that region of the environment, so I should be finding a safe place for my tasks and for my well-being, for example. So that means training your model according to the environmental factors and according to the feedbacks giving as yes, that is true, that is false, and yes, that is good, that is bad. That is means also learning by experiences. That is called as the reinforcement learning in terms of machine learning. And there is the semi-supervised learning. That means your data may be including some inputs which are associated with outputs, and some of inputs maybe not including outputs. Maybe they are missing or not detected from previous data gathering steps. So you can be running semi-supervised learning. In that way, your system just associate the outputs for the inputs not having outputs, so that reach to a semi-supervised learning style, dear friends. Yes, when we talk more about the AI-based cybersecurity, we should be considering the expert knowledge, as I included, as I explained in the previous slides, and we should be having some experience-oriented data to feed our system. And we have some algorithmic actions, which leads to an artificial intelligence-based cybersecurity component. And in terms of different problems of cybersecurity, we can be using direct AI-based algorithms like artificial neural networks, like fuzzy logic, which means direct usage in terms of the target problem. Or we can be using hybrid use, for example, one problem side can be solved by artificial neural networks and the other side can be solved with fuzzy logic. So we combine different solutions by different students to run to a common solution for your target problem. So that means hybrid usage of artificial intelligence for cybersecurity. It's actually even in different fields, you can be using forming hybrid systems. That's a very trendy topic in terms of research. In order to improve your accuracy, in order to improve performance of your results, you can be combining different AI-based systems, like including one machine learning technique and including another technique, which is not machine learning, for example, like fuzzy logic, for example, to reach to an advanced form of hybrid system. And of course, you can be using as the supportive components, the AI, for the traditional methods. For example, the AI-based system can be giving some decision-making to a ethical hacker, to a human, for example. So it can be used for improving efficiency of the human's actions. While working on a pen test, penetration testing, you can be having some feedback from an AI-based system, which is also working on the target system, which is tested with penetration methods. So you can be collaboratively working on the same system. So the AI just supports you. It just supports the human side, which is a way of the improving your performance, for example, and having better results at the end. Maybe it can be detecting some hidden points, like you cannot be seeing them because of your human limitations, but the digital system, AI-based system, can be doing that instead of you, like that. And of course, you can be using agent-based systems. Agent means that's the use of different AI-based algorithms, which are communicating each other, like using IoT-based devices, like using optimization-based algorithms. They are just communicating each other to provide a collaborative solution. But in that scenario, there is no human, and at least directly, there is not human. Indirectly, you may be controlling the environment, but like robots or like the swarm-based drones, for example, the software component-based agent systems are communicating each other to perform a cyber attack or to perform a cyber defensive solutions for your company system, maybe. And of course, when we consider the machine learning and deep learning, you should be having or you should be careful about how to train your system with some data, and you should be test your system with some known data in terms of output, so you can be having idea about how your system will be act for future states, because not every system, machine learning system, can be learning enough about the target problem. So you can be using them in terms of target applications, in terms of real manner and future states. And that is the important side of the modeling of your problem. If you miss anything from your problem, your system will be unuseful, for example. And of course, you should be having true data. That is the job of the data scientists, especially not machine learning engineers and developers, but the data scientist is responsible for the gathering the true data and balanced data. That may be another topic for another webinar, maybe in the future, but that is a very critical problem. And the training phase is very important. Maybe you may be needing some more amounts of time to train your system. So these components are important for especially machine learning and, of course, deep learning, considering today's state, for the cybersecurity-oriented intelligence systems. And currently, there is a great intense use of IoT-based systems, and they are rising more and more, as you can see. And we are going to a brave smart world, which will be including smart components, which are controlling our health state, which are controlling our well-being, which are communicating each other to ensure a smart environment, which do not us directly, do not need us directly, but they need our data to control a life for as a supportive component for our daily life. But that brings us some problems, of course, dear friends. The more complex systems, the more use of such systems out of our control means that we have less control of such systems, so that improves the potential dangerous side of cybersecurity. So use of Internet of Things, wearables, sensors, unmanned machines, distributed computing, blockchain and IoT-based solutions, of course, in terms of privacy and data security, and use of big data, of course, because today's smart systems use not only, for example, data from a certain sensor, but they use even our social media data and everything we are doing during daily life. So there is a big complex side of the data, and such